to the 148th commencement of Findlay High School. Congratulations to the class of 2020. I invite everyone to please stand, gentlemen, to remove your hats, and everyone to join the Findlay High School Men's Ensemble in singing our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that
be seated. Once again, welcome to the 148th commencement of Findlay High School. There are so many people that have played an important role in getting these young people to where they are today. Parents, grandparents, brothers, sisters, friends, neighbors, and teachers. And now, Findlay City Schools is pleased to recognize our honored guest. Board of Education President, Dr. Kathy Siebenauer-Wilson. Board of Education Vice President, Mrs. Susan Russell. Board of Education Members, Mr. Matt Cooper. Mr. Chris Aldrich. Ms. Laura Iyer. Superintendent, Mr. Edward Kurt. Assistant Superintendent, Mr. Troy Roth. Associate Principal, Mr. David Alvarado. Assistant Principals, Mr. Michael Letty. Mrs. Christine Siebenek. Mrs. Meg Simon. Faculty President, Mr. Jimmy Orr. It is now my pleasure to welcome once again Mr. Edward Kurt.
Good morning. Today is a day that these graduates have anticipated for quite some time. They have dreamed about it, and even maybe prayed about it. And graduates in the class of 2020, I am sure that you are excited about today. Congratulations. I want to tell you how proud the administrative team is of your fortitude through these trying times. No senior class has faced this type of ending of their senior year, and you have our respect. I also realize that nobody woke this morning excited and motivated to face the day in anticipation of the superintendent's comments at graduation ceremony. However, I do hope that you will listen and really hear some suggestions or points that may be of help. I would like to take some time to thank some special people that have helped our graduates with their dedicated and devoted efforts made them arrive here today. It wouldn't be possible for these graduates to be here without their support. The entire education community of the Findlay City Schools, we thank you for your work and dedication to our 2020 seniors. Former graduates paved the way for our 2020 seniors, and we thank you. Parents and grandparents of our graduates, your support and love of our 2020 seniors is so important, especially through these tough times. We thank you. Those who have served or are serving in our armed forces, we thank you. Our frontline firefighters, paramedics, hospital staff, and medical professionals daily fighting the COVID-19 pandemic, we thank you. To each of these groups, we thank you for your commitment to these graduates, and in the case of our armed forces, your commitment to our country. We are extremely proud of this class, whether beginning a career in the armed forces, the workforce, or attending college. Your ability to impact this community or another community that you choose to live in will be controlled by you. In no small part, your contributions to our school system and community have paid it forward to cultivate future success as a school system and as our community in general. Thank you. And looking back to when I sat in my graduation ceremony many decades ago, I want to pass on what I think is important. Number one, the older you get, the more intelligent your parents will become. Use your parents and loved ones for advice and guidance as you move on with your life beyond high school. Peer pressure should have no influence over you unless it is pressure to become successful and make positive, productive decisions. Pressure regarding making destructive or non-productive decisions should be ignored, and actions and events that are right for your life should be made. Number three, caring and compassion for all human beings, regardless of religion, race, or creed, should be a priority. If you want to do something in your life that really feels good, then help someone and make a positive difference in someone's life. Number four, life is precious. Through the events of the COVID-19 pandemic, we have seen heroic actions of many people across our country. Each of you I challenge to work and to have a voice to make our and your way of life better. Each of you have a voice to be heard to make a difference moving forward. Have balance in your life. Education and earning a living and being a productive citizen is very important. Those things can only be accomplished with true happiness if you are a person that has balance in your physical, your mental, and your spiritual side of your life. Balance means that you have a handle on the various aspects of your life. Don't stress over the little things. What may seem like a crisis now, as you look back, is not a big deal at all. Keep issues and events in perspective. Move forward in a positive direction, keeping focus on your goals and your core values. Maximize your ability. Alan Loy McGinnis, an author and counselor, stated, "The distribution of talent in the world should not be our concern. Our responsibility is to take the talents that we have and ardently parlay them to the highest possible achievement." Whether you took advantage of advanced placement courses, college credit plus options, needed assistance with remediation, or took advantage of our career tech programs does not matter. What matters is that you found an area that you have a passion to excel in, and if you didn't find it, there is still plenty of time for you to accomplish finding that field or area where your passion exists, and you can maximize your abilities. Basically, my challenge to each of you graduates is to be the best you that you can be. Graduates, again, we are extremely proud of you, and you will be missed. But as alumnus of Findlay High School, I wish you success and happiness throughout your lives. Again, congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Kurt. Now, Mr. Roth will introduce the 2020 salutatorian.
The 2020 Findlay High School salutatorian is Michael Copeland. Michael's the son of Steve and Dawn Copeland. While at Findlay High School, Michael was a two-year member of the varsity soccer team. He was also involved in Findlay First Edition his senior year. Next fall, Michael plans on attending the University of Pittsburgh to major in biological sciences. The title of his speech is Looking Forward.
Good morning. Congratulations to the class of 2020. I am honored to be here today to share a few words with all of you. I have grown significantly as a person during my years at Findlay High School, and there are many people I'd like to thank for that, as I could not have done it alone. Before I give recognition to a few impactful people in my life, I would like to first congratulate each and every one of you who has taken this journey with me, as it has not been easy. I would also like to thank all the faculty and staff that made this virtual event possible during these uncertain times. A lot of hard work went into planning and organizing the ceremony, and I am very thankful we are still given this time of recognition. To all the people who have supported me throughout my life, I would like to say thank you. Thank you to my dad, who would watch me struggle for up to 30 minutes at a time searching for an answer online, to grab my textbook and find the set answer in 10 seconds or fewer. Thank you to my mom, who has put countless miles on her car, driving me to and from soccer for the past 10 years. Thank you to my sisters, who have always been there for me in their own special way, and the rest of my family for always supporting me, no matter what. Thank you to all the teachers who have supported my academics, and finally, thank you to all of my friends I've made and all the laughs we've shared. The late Jimmy Dean famously states, "I can't change the direction of the wind, but I can adjust my sails to always reach my destination." Looking back on his words, they certainly seem applicable to the end of the 2020 school year, and that no one could have expected or planned for the end of our school year being what it is today. Yet it is up to us to stay positive moving forward and adapt to this changing world around us in order to achieve everything we had previously set out to do. Change may not always be welcome, but it's up to each and every one of us to make the most out of challenging situations. Even though we will shortly be going our separate ways, we will always share the experiences and memories made at Findlay High School. I am thankful to be a part of such a great class and to have met so many amazing people. We can hold fast to the time and the memories we have spent and made at Findlay High School, which will strengthen and support our resolves and move forward in life. Thank you.
The class of 2020 chose as their theme, "You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes, you can steer yourself any direction you choose," by Dr. Seuss. Our first speaker is Megan Quesada. Megan is the daughter of Brent and Jenny Quesada. While at Findlay High School, Megan was involved in cross country, track, speech and debate, and was treasurer of National Honor Society. She has been on the Distinguished Honor Roll and received the Scholar Athlete Award all 4 years of high school. Next fall, she plans on attending The Ohio State University to pursue a degree in nursing. The title of her speech is "The Next Step."
Looking back at the past 13 years that we have been going to school together, there have been a lot of steps to get to the place we are today. There have been big steps that I will talk about, but there have also been a lot of smaller ones. Some of these are the people we become friends with, the things we choose to be involved in within the school and community, and the adults we decide to look up to. Everything we have done all these years, no matter how big or small, has shaped us. The big steps started with primary school, learning our letters, numbers, and how to spell our names. This step was scary. It was the first time we left our homes by ourselves. We had to try to remember the entire alphabet, how to tell time, and that sharing is caring. Then we went on to intermediate school. Everything got harder. We took the numbers we had already learned and had to do real math with them. We went through the stress of times tests and the constant reminder that we had to be on our best behavior or the middle school teachers would not like it. Then we moved on to middle school. The school got bigger, there were more people, and let me tell you, the math got harder. We got thrown into the world of algebra, team sports, and being told this would prepare us for high school. And finally, we made it to the most recent step, high school. Walking into the high school at freshman orientation, I can remember feeling like I would never know my way around. As we have made our way through high school, it's gotten smaller and smaller the more comfortable we have become. The math classes have still gotten harder as we have made our way through Algebra 2 and Calculus. We have had the opportunity to become more involved in our school and community, and we have been told over and over again that this will prepare us for the future. Every time being told this would prepare us for the future, that future felt so far away, but it seems we have made it. Up until now, our main steps have all looked relatively similar, but this future can look different for everyone. Whether the next step is going into the workforce, additional education, entering the military, or starting a family, we have all made it to the future. Calling this the future makes it seem like the end, but in reality, we should never stop taking steps, no matter how big or small the steps feel. From here on out, the steps will be less defined as they have been in the past. No one will be reminding us every day about what we are being prepared for and where to go next. The beauty of this is that we get to choose. It is our turn to decide the steps we take. Things will not always make sense, but in everything we do, we will be preparing for what is to come. I am thankful that we have had the opportunity to take these first steps together, and that when it feels like we make the wrong choices, we have each other to fall back on. I look forward to seeing all the steps and directions we choose to steer ourselves in the future. As I come to the end of my nostalgia about the past, I want to emphasize that even if we fail, we have to keep moving forward. As Dr. Seuss writes, you have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes, you can steer yourself any direction you choose. I can confidently say that the class of 2020 is headed in the right direction. Thank you.
Please enjoy the Findlay High School Symphonic Choir as they sing Seasons of Love. Our next speaker is Megan Quaid. Megan is the daughter to Jewel and John Quaid and sister to Molly and Will. While at Findlay High School, Megan was involved in Teen Institute, Teen Lead, Junior Statesman of America, National Honor Society, Varsity Swimming, and spent time volunteering at the local library. Next fall, Megan plans on attending Penn State University and majoring in English with a concentration in creative writing. The title of her speech is The World on Our Shoulders.
For those of you who know me, it won't come as a surprise when I say I spent a lot of time in high school totally stressed out. The stress of the ACT, my first choir exam, the honors lab, swim meets, and many more responsibilities piled on top of each other and led to many long nights that ended with me praying for the end of high school to come more quickly. Yet today, I find myself wishing for just a few more days of high school. Just enough days to experience the last that I've been so excited about since the very first day. Just one more study hall in Mr. Laux's room. One more day singing in symphonic choir. One more lunch with my friends. One more ride home from school with my sister. And just one more day controlled by that bell. I had spent my time in high school looking forward to those last blissful months of senior year when everything starts to get much easier. The months when your biggest concern is finding a prom dress and not the anatomy final. The months when the weather starts to get warmer and the homework load cools off. The months when you focus on finding your real friends and cherish the last moments with your favorite teachers. Those last months when the weight of the world we've carried on our shoulders starts to feel a lot lighter. Instead, these last few months of high school were spent in our homes, trying to understand how 13 years of schooling could possibly end like this. But I'm going to be honest, I'm not as sad as I thought I would be. I mean, sure, the initial shock of it all was intense and scary, and I might have spent more time crying than I should have about missing out on the end of my senior year. Then I remembered all of the reasons I have to be thankful. I got to spend more time with my family before I go to college. I was able to do my homework inside or outside or whenever I wanted. I was able to have sleepovers with my sister and play basketball outside with my brother. But most importantly, I was able to and can continue to do most of the things I enjoy because I am healthy, and that is what I am most thankful for. I guess I find it difficult to be sad when all of the people I really care about are healthy and happy at a time when many are not. The unique situation has really given us an opportunity to see our place in the world and show us that our small contributions to one another can really make a big difference. Missing senior prom and the last days at FHS is really disappointing, but we are the class that will be forever remembered for staying home to save lives. So when I reminisce about my time in high school, I won't be sad or angry that I missed out on the typical high school milestones. I will be proud of our class, and I will look back fondly at the many amazing memories I made every day while I was lucky enough to be at Findlay High School. I really hope that the class of 2020 will embrace all of the days each of us were able to enjoy together instead of lingering on what we missed. Our class, more than any other, will carry with them the importance of making every day count and will be thankful for every day we had together. To all of my teachers and advisors, thank you for your endless time and dedication and caring. To my best friends, you made every day so much fun. To my family, I love you. And to the class of 2020, it's time to go out and show the world that we are ready for anything. Thank you.
And now, I invite everyone to stand. Gentlemen, to remove your hats, and all to join in singing the alma mater of Findlay High School.
Come on. Thank you.
Everyone, please be seated. Mr. Imke will now present the class of 2020 for graduation.
It is now my pleasure to present for graduation the 148th Findlay High School senior class. These students have excelled in many areas, including music, drama, career technical education, athletics, community service, and many other activities. We are particularly proud of the academic success of the class of 2020. Mr. Kurt, members of the Board of Education, these young men and women have completed the graduation requirements established by the Findlay City Board of Education in the state of Ohio, and are now ready to receive their diplomas. Dr. Siebenhauer-Wilson, it is an honor to present for graduation the class of 2020.
Good morning. On behalf of the Findlay City Schools Board of Education, we congratulate and honor you, the Findlay High School class of 2020. After 13 years, it is time for you to claim your rite of passage into the next chapter of your life. I would be remiss to say that we are following a time-honored tradition of graduations. Thus, it has been difficult for me to find the right words to share with you so that you would truly know the significance of this ceremony. What I do know, class of 2020, is that you will long remember this time, and you will be long remembered as our heroes. Looking back to 27, Findlay experienced the 100-year flood. Most of you were beginning kindergarten. Our town was ravished. Some of your families may have lost their homes or possessions. Your teachers and administrators went through the schools to see which were accessible and usable. You started school late that year. Our world was turned upside down, but we pulled together and we got through it. You were our young Trojan heroes that year. The difference in what has occurred now during your senior year is that something came to our country that we have not seen before. Unlike the flood, where we could at least see the water and know where we could go and eventually learn to navigate around it, the COVID-19 pandemic hit our country and spread until it engulfed our state and finally our county. Unlike the floodwater that we could see, we cannot see the virus or how to navigate around it yet. A superintendent in the state said early on, "We will never know if we did too much, but we will know if we did too little." Being the community we are, the school district we are, and the students you are, even without being able to see the virus, we are learning to navigate around it. Has it caused things to be different? Absolutely. And I see the class of 2020, our Trojans, as being our heroes again. It was on a Thursday you went to school, like a pretty normal day, and on Friday your teachers and administrators were doing fast work on the what if. Over the weekend, we realized that you would not be seeing your teachers or principals again, and that you would fast turn into virtual students with remote teaching and learning. I've struggled with what to say to make that feel any different for you. I've watched and listened to many express their feelings about this. Then finally, I was inspired by hearing a letter that was written by Bill Darling, who is a high school track and cross-country coach. As time marched by, it became inevitable that there would be no spring sports. In Coach Darling's letter to his team, in part, he writes, quote, There is a song making the rounds these days. It was written by Eric Isnick called True Heroes. In it he sings, "True heroes are measured by what they give away." In the spring of 2020, for you seniors, you gave up a lot. You gave up most of the last part of your senior year, prom, traditional graduation, and your last track season. Coach Darling goes on to say, "You would be far better to look not at what you had taken away, but what you've been given. You gave it up to save the lives of your friends, your family, and many people who you never have met. You know, in all likelihood, you may have been fine, but others may have been in peril. In the next few years, I ask you to look around the table. Keep your eyes up in your community. See them. Know there are people who will be with us for years to come, people who are so precious and valuable in our lives. They will be here because of what you have given away." End quote. The words of the song go like this: "True heroes are remembered for how they lived each day. True heroes are measured by what they give away." Now take a look at our problems. So many voices calling out to me and you. True heroes are the ones who always answer just because it's the right thing to do. Looking out for one another, keeping faith despite the doubt, reaching out to help each other, isn't that what life's about? True heroes are remembered for how they live each day. True heroes are measured by what they give away. True heroes are treasured for what they give away. In closing, we salute you, our Trojan heroes, the Findlay High School class of 2020. We will treasure your memory. Thank you for your pride, your spirit, and your giving. May you always remain Trojan true. Mr. Imke, on behalf of the Findlay City Schools Board of Education, it is our honor and privilege to accept the Findlay High School class of 2020. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Siebenaller Wilson. Mr. Imke will now honor our valedictorian, our salutatorian, and our 4.0 students by calling their names first.
Graduates, it's finally time. It is my pleasure to recognize the valedictorian, the salutatorian, and our 4.0 students. Megan Louise Earhart. Michael Aaron Copeland. Reagan Lenz Black. Megan Jane Casada. Nolan John Klaus. Ashley Marie Coleman. Kelsey Ruth Coleman. John Xavier Conrad. Hannah Isabel Gary. Dominic Alexander Mora. Cade Everett Odell. James Braden Richards. Lindsay Kristen Ritzler. Carl David Rupp. Drew Michael Swisher. Stephen Michael Winteringham.
Alec Broderick
Adkins. Arleth Anahi Aguado. Alma Beatrice Aguilar. Donald Ray Anderson. Alexander Devin Armstrong. Simone Kathleen Lenore Arredondo. Chandler Reese Artresia. Paige Elizabeth Bailey. Emily Ann Baker. Branson Caleb Barker. Kylie Sage Bates. Austin Nicholas Bateson. Gabrielle Alina Marie Bumgardner. Samantha Lee Beal. Nathan Mansfield Beatty. Jordan Gary Bechtel. Taylor Lynn Beckley. Francesca R. Bejarano. Olivia Felice Benjamin. Madison Renee Berry. Macy Betts. Alexis Ray Bibler. Kane Allen Bickelhall. Sophie Christine Blackburn. Jillian Taylor Bland. Gabrielle William Boblins. Marshall Nathaniel Bott. Jessica Dawn Bowman. Claudia Marie Brown. Michaela Ashley Brown. Chase David Bronowell. Raymond Joseph Brumball. Ethan Michael Robert Buck. Blaze Allen Kane. Nicole Renee Kane. Trevor Eugene Campbell. Ethan Joseph Canterbury. Precious Star Lynn Carver. Emily Marie Cattell. Madison Bailey Conter. Keith Bernard Chappelle. Kayla Jean Chatelain. Kevin William Chavez. Charles Thomas Clapper. Austin Jeffrey Click. Elizabeth Adelie Clifton. Maria Rose Conauer. Emma Blair Cook. Aiden Charles Copeland. Kaylin Alyssa Couch. Gavin Michael Catino. Dominic Neil Kramer. Kenneth Gabrielle Cunningham. Denisha Shawanta Davis. Hannah Lynn Davis. Jaden Ayala Dawson. Rebecca Elaine Day. Reese Richard Kyle Day. Cross Alexander Dela Cruz. Anna Irene Detterman. Angelette Isabel Diaz Nava. Grant Ryan Dickman. Anna Gabriella Deal. Patrick Michael Dillon. Stephen Allen Distel. Alexis Marie Doe. Tyler Andrew Doe. Claire Therese Debker. Jasmine Lee Doring. Virginia LaRose Lee Doyle. Emily Jeanette Duplessis. Owen Andrew Eckenrode. Anaya Marie Ellis. Mitchell Allen Emmeheiser. Bennett Allen Woodrow Emmerich. Chloe Marie Edelman. Joshua Zachariah Erland. Javen Dwayne Essinger. Aiden Paul Eubanks.
Allison Nicole Fast. Cecilia Marie Fiesel. Chloe Elizabeth Fiesel. William Thomas Federka. Elizabeth Kate Fetterman. Parker Evan Fetterman. Austin Dean Fluga. Hallie Rose Fluga. Damon Anthony Francis. Keaton William Frank. Tanner Alexander Fryer. Madeline Lee Falk. Leah Bryn Fuller. Moses Gabriel Gaines. Madison Ray Gallen. Jacob Dale Gangle. Brooklyn Gail Gelball. Elijah James George. Jacob Anthony Ross George. Carson Seth Gertz. Ashley Nicole Glick. Kennedy Grace Goble. Gabriel Michael Gonzalez. Unique Renee Gonzalez. Elijah Rayshon Gordon. Troy Foster Gross. Danielle Kayla Gerges. Derek Isaiah Guzman. Tobias Everett Haas. David Allen Hackenberg. Riley Christian Haynes. Dylan Joseph Hall. Harrison Stewart Hall. Brandon Torres Hamilton. Dalton James Hanna. Shadow Clark Hansen. Desiree Marie Hardwick. Caitlin Louise Hardwick. Catherine Aaron Harp. Ashton Ray Harris. Graham Day Hartman. Samuel Isaac Hartman. Brianne Morgan Howenstein. Destiny Betty Honstein. Haley Noelle Heckerman. Emma Elizabeth Heidelball. Abigail Grace Heasted. Emma Nicole Hellman. Matthew Barrett Heminger. Millie Maxine Hernandez. Lila Mercedes Hicks. Elijah Thomas Hingson. Lily Emma Hodson. Austin Scott Hostler. Ethan Christopher Hunt. Chloe Isabel Ibera. Micah Isaiah Jackson. Lexus Danielle Jenkins. Braden Zeke Elijah Johnson. Celia Leanne Johnson. Isaiah Roselle Johnson. Morris Lamont Johnson. Alyssa May Uhas. Kira Elena Kmeyer. Michael K. Olivia Marie Kempfer. Allison Claire Kennard. Charles Robert Kimberly. Emma Jillian Clausing. Terrell James Klingler. Gregory James Konechny. Chloe Lynn Korecki. Nicholas Andrew Cram. Callie Marie Kramer. William Thomas Kring.
Jessica Ann Lagerquist. Jacob Ross Lamaster. Emma Grace Lammers. Cheyenne Ray Large. Ezra Matthias Larson. Arabella Marie Lawmeyer. Margot Claire Lazar. Nicholas James Utoma. Jennifer Mary Longo. Alice Liu. Logan Keith Mabe. Caleb Reed Martin. Anthony Ruben Martinez. Rayleigh Nicole Martinez. Andrea Rose Maddox. Baden Allen May. Drew Vaughn McLean. Renee Louise McDonald. Shayla Trine McDonald. Elena Raquel McKernan. Gavin Keith McGrill. Zoya Leah Meeks. Ava Marcella Meyer. Emily Kristen Middleton. Faith Elizabeth Middleton. Noah Wilson Middleton. Gabriel Elias Muir. Cameron Douglas Might. Colin Joseph Miller. Keaton Lewis Miller. Wyatt Allen Miller. Taylor Jamila Mitchell. Alexander Ryan Robert Monroe. Olivia Ann Montgomery. Abraham Yushin Moon. Isaiah Jackie Moore. Tavion Azure Moore. Evan Jeffrey Morse. Okay. Mary Megan Mosier. Danielle Tayana Moss. Anthony Richard Moyer. Anthony Dwayne Murphy. Mateo Issa Navarro. Julius Robert Nikki Hottenstein. Jacob William New. Larry James New. Monica Nunez. Casey Aaron Oates. Abigail Marie Omler. Logan Patrick Owens. Esperanza Noemi Palacios. Tessa Nicole Tabrina Pascal. Timothy Michael Pascal. Molly Kate Patterson. Gabriella Courtney Pergram. Nicholas Allen Phillips. Caleb Michael Pilcher. Kiana Marie Potter. Zoe Elizabeth Powell. Joshua Allen Preterati. Nandi Sherry Pritchett. Jocelyn Mary Poofty. Storm Mackenzie Poofty. Owen Maximilian Peschel. Megan Quaid. Gabrielle Dyrese Quarles. Brady Michael Rabel. Michaela Ann Rawl. Kendall Vittoria Ray. Haley Marie Rail. Robert William Reed. Brianna Elizabeth Rice. Jacob Dwan Rickman. Kaylee Victoria Reidenauer. Tyler Lee Ryder. Samuel Vincent Reby. Gabriel Scott Riker. Matthew Stephen Risser. Maurice Twister Rivera. Braden Charles William Rogers. Deidre Diane Rose. Ariana Noel Rausch. Gabrielle Lauren Russell. Riley Devin Russell.
Austin Thomas Saldana. Zachary Matthew Saldana. Mason Andrew Salliers. Seth William Shade. Alexis Marie Schiltz. Ross Charles Schiltz. Grant Russell Schrader. Trenton William Owen Scott. Brianna Marie Searles. Sierra Michaela Selig. Aaron Faith Settlemeyer. Anthony James Sherman. Ian Ray Schindeldecker. Jessica Ann Schisler. Michaela Jo Slough. Jasmine Amaya Smith. Joseph Daniel Smith. Caitlin Nicole Smith. Stephen Soyasanga. Alexander Mitchell Spar. Rhiannon Aurora Melancholy Sparks. Ethan Christopher Spradlin. Sydney Michelle Starr. Jacob Allen Story. Michaela Renee Stoltz. Haley K. Swanger. Ryan Seth Sweet. Shelby Mackenzie Tate. Amy Rita Chevy. Blake Ryan Tennyson. Savannah Rain Teal. Blaine Michael Tom. Nicholas James Thomas. Tanner Joel Timbrook. Dakota Lee Todd. Ashlyn Janelle Tong. Jordan Ray Tracy. Cassia Dawn Treese. Logan Andrew Treese. Amanda Marie Tremaines. Jessica Rose Tremaines. Romeo Itu Tulioma. Morgan Elizabeth Tyree. Miyu Uchiyama. Hannah Nicole Eulinger. Logan Alexander Ulrich. Mason Thor Vanetta. Noah Michael Vandermark. Allison Anne Marie Van Warmer. Daniel Anthony Vela. Jaden Darnell Velezquez. Marquise Wayne Vermillion. Casey Lynn Wagner. Laurel Ann Waite. Pierce Alexander Waite. Hunter Matthew Wallen. Kendra Elise Waller. Eliza Jabari Washington. Jordan Anthony Martin Weaver. Sabrina Monet Weaver. Dakota Lee Weekly. Danielle Elizabeth Weitzel. Ava Nicole Welch. Sky Rochelle Wells. Cole Daniel Westrick. Isaac Allen Wetmore. Justin William Wilcox. Sierra Christine Williams. Lorenzo Hakeem Wilson. Zedric Robert Richard Wilson. Jaden Alexander Wilt. Matthew James Whitty. Joseph Charles Wool. Dylan Michael Wolbers. Jared Zachary Woods. Jaden Lee Woodward. Ava Rebecca Woolley. Emma Grace Wright. Michael Lowell Younger. Brooklyn Sue Zoller. Carlos Francisco Zaragoza Preciado. Ella Dale Zavisha. Brandon Tyler Zimmerman.
Congratulations to the Findlay High School Class of 2020. And now, Mr. Troy Roth will recognize the valedictorian of the Class of 2020.
The 2020 Findlay High School valedictorian is Megan Earhart. Megan is the daughter of Marty and John Earhart. Next fall, she plans to attend Tulane University in New Orleans to study chemical engineering and Spanish. While at Findlay High School, Megan was active with the tennis team and was captain her senior year. She was also president of the National Honor Society during her senior year and a member during her junior year. She participated in orchestra, chamber orchestra, and Spanish club. She has volunteered at the YMCA and public library. The title of Megan's speech is Three Lessons of High School.
Good morning, everyone. While obviously this is not how I've been picturing my high school graduation for years, I'm still glad I have the opportunity to share some of my thoughts with you. High school has been a wild ride, from lighting tortilla chips on fire in freshman science, to playing The Sims for a project in sophomore English, dissecting a mink in anatomy, and finally doing all of my schoolwork in my bed for the end of my senior year. I want to share the three most memorable lessons I've learned in the past 4 years. The first lesson I've learned is build up your support system. I remember one of the first days of my freshman year, I earned an F on my summer reading from my English teacher. I bawled. It was probably the worst thing that could have happened to me at that time. After school that day, I had a tennis match and my mom and my best friend Muskan were there, and they made me feel so much better. They convinced me that one grade at the beginning of freshman year was not the end of the world, and life would go on. It did, to better grades and less crying. Without them, I would not have had the confidence to keep going and try again. A support system is important at many times, including but not limited to bad grades, and we will all need strong support in the coming years. The next steps of our lives are going to be challenging, but the world is before us. With the right people behind you, you can do anything. The second lesson I learned is, it's not always about you. It's important not to forget that other people in the world have issues that don't have anything to do with you, and there's not a lot you can do about it. COVID-19 is a great example. No one wants to be doing this right now, but I'm thankful to everyone that's staying home. I'm devastated that I won't be able to have a normal end to my senior year. And there's no making up for that. While I hate not being able to go to prom, have a real graduation, or have my grad party as scheduled, these sacrifices are necessary to save lives. Coronavirus also means we will always remember our senior year, for better or worse. I've still managed to make memories, including watching my dad and his friends try to figure out Zoom, exchanging baked goods with my friends, and going on lots of walks with my mom. Just because the world is on hold doesn't mean our lives are. Take this time to reflect on your life so far and make the next chapter of it the best yet. The third lesson I learned is believe in yourself. If you don't, you'll never be able to reach your full potential. This obviously has some limits, but there are so many things we can do that we think we cannot. For example, if someone had told me my freshman year that I would have to write a 12-page paper for my English class my senior year, I would have said, no way, that's so long, that's so many words, I can't. But I did last December. I did not enjoy it. However, this experience in high school will enable me to do it again when necessary. There are many things in life that we have to endure, and you just have to get through it. In the next few years, we will all do things we never thought we were capable of, and we will also all fail at some point and make mistakes. And that's okay. That's how we learn. We all need to be brave and face the world head on. These three lessons: build up your support system, it's not all about you, and believe in yourself, are more important than many of the academic concepts we've learned in high school, but they go hand in hand. Teachers teach about science and writing and music, but they also teach about life. Experience is the best teacher, and I hope you all have been listening. I want to thank all of my teachers and everyone who has made a difference in my life, but specifically my parents, Sean Swisher, Mark Laux, and Judy Withrow. Thank you to the class of 2020 for making my years at FHS memorable, and best of luck in the future. We will do great things. Now, will the class of 2020 please join me in turning their tassels from the right to the left? Congratulations.
It is now my great honor and privilege to join with my fellow faculty members in celebrating the class of 2020.
Now we all march on together, we all march on
Thank you, faculty, for joining the celebration of graduates. Wow, you have done it. One of my favorite coaches of all time is Lou Holtz. He said, "Show me someone who has done something worthwhile, and I'll show you someone who has overcome adversity." Class of 2020, you have truly managed adversity through unprecedented times. You are now ready to go and make your mark on the world. Congratulations to the class of 2020 on this tremendous accomplishment. And these achievements are only the beginning. I can tell you, as a Findlay High School graduate, that the learning and experiences you have gained will positively impact you for the rest of your life. You will truly forever be a Trojan. Thank you, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay Trojan true. Thank you, and go Trojans.